Hey guys, it's Warren here, and today we are going to be taking a look at the Worx Landroid, specifically how you set it up, how the mower runs, and importantly, some of the security features to make sure no one can steal your new robot lawnmower.
Now, here's a look at my lawn, and as you can see, it's not huge, so for that reason, I've got the Landroid S300 for up to 300 meters squared. Plus, I've also put down some additional turf to make a home, especially for the Landroid's charging station. Now, with a smaller garden, as space is more at a premium, I'm using the bare minimum requirements for the space required for the charging station. Therefore, I do feel it was going to be hit and miss as to whether the mower will be able to dock and dismount the charging station successfully in such a confined space, but we'll find out if it can do it later. And for reference, the docking station needs a minimum 30cm clearance on the left and 80cm on the right. In addition, I've also got an irrigation system, and in the manual it's recommended to keep the Landroid away from it, so I've wrapped some self-amalgamating tape around the dripping holes that are near the docking station. And now I'm happy with the placement, I can secure the docking station to the grass using the included screws and Allen key. And now it's time for the next part of the setup, powering everything on. Initially, the LED light should go from green to red, and the red light means that the boundary wire currently isn't connected. So what we can do whilst we're laying our boundary wire is charge the Landroid mower up. So insert the 20 volt battery into the back, and then place the mower onto the charging station so the charging points make contact. Now, the boundary wire is an essential part of the setup, because this is what tells the Landroid where the edges of your lawn are. Specifically, this will tell the Landroid when it needs to turn around because it's reached the edge of your lawn, plus your Landroid will also follow your boundary wire when it's doing an edge cut. And laying your boundary wire is actually really simple and doesn't actually take that long. How you do it is you connect one end of your boundary wire to the red contact point of the charging station, feed it through the base, and then start pegging it down to the lawn. My flower beds run flush with the lawn, which means I only need to leave a 10cm gap between the boundary wire and the flower beds. And if you want your Landroid to make a perfect right-hand turn on an outside corner, use the cardboard triangle you get with the mower and lay the boundary wire around it as shown. And if you don't have a flush border, for example if you have decking, you then need to leave a 26cm gap between your boundary wire and the decking. I also recommend leaving some excess pieces of boundary wire like shown in case your borders change. When you have two pieces of boundary wire next to each other like this, each wire cancels each other out and therefore the mower will ignore them, so it's great for planning ahead. And once you've laid your boundary wire all the way around your lawn, returning to the charging station, simply trim the wire and connect it to the remaining connector on the dock. And within a short period of time, your grass should have grown over your boundary wire so you can no longer see it. And now for the next step, let's set up the Landroid mower itself. And this can be done easily using the Landroid app by scanning the QR code on the back of the mower. And this allows you to easily connect your mower to your Wi-Fi network. And now to set up the security features. Firstly, you can only manually turn on the Landroid mower by inputting a PIN number that only you have set. Secondly, you can enable an alarm so if someone tries to steal your mower, it will sound when it's lifted. And for peace of mind, your mower will stop working if it's disconnected from your Wi-Fi network after a period of time. So all in all, you have very little to worry about when leaving your Landroid in your garden on its own. And now it's time to leave my Landroid to perform its maiden mow of my lawn. Now, firstly, what's great, the Landroid seems to reverse slightly at an angle before coming off the charging station, which means I've left plenty of space for when it's disembarking. I also set the Landroid app to auto-schedule, which means initially, whilst it's still learning about the lawn, it took about 45 minutes to mow each session. And after a week, auto-schedule has now set itself to mow 7 days a week at about 15 minutes per session with 2 edge cuts. And the edge cut feature is genuinely brilliant. It does a really good job at going all the way up to the edge of the lawn, making sure the edges are kept nice and trim. It does a great job of this both on the flower beds and also on a patio area I have that's flush with the lawn. And now for that bit I was worried about, will it be able to squeeze back into that space to recharge? And thankfully, it did. And now we're going to look at the anti-collision system, ACS, that you can also get for your Landroid. This is basically a device that detects obstacles in front of the mower so it can then slalom around them. It's an add-on you can purchase and it's super simple to install simply by connecting the wires and screwing it into place. But how well does it work? Bring on the testing ground. If, like me, you have a small child, and if that usually means your garden's quite messy, then this is something that's definitely worth considering. The ACS device genuinely does a great job at slaloming around objects before it hits them. And what's also great, it also does them with minimal clearance. No matter what size the obstacle is, for example, if it's a thin washing line or a big round space hopper. So, there you have it. There are my first impressions of the Worx Landroid. I think it's great because it takes one less thing off my jobs list in the summer, plus it is actually really easy to set up. I was genuinely worried about the security implications and what if someone wanted to steal the Landroid, but I've since learned that because of those security features we mentioned earlier, it's built so it can only be used within the perimeter of the lawn in which it was set up. In addition, you can genuinely leave the Landroid to just do its thing and just not worry about it at all. The auto schedule feature means that it will just figure out what it needs to do and when, and you can just leave it to it. All in all, I think it's the perfect robotic addition to my home, and also be sure to look out for forthcoming videos on how to maintain your Landroid mower and a review of my lawn after the summer, all on my YouTube channel.